You know me, I'm not a fan of the long intro. Let's dive into Industry Baby by Lil Nas X, featuring Jack Harlow, produced by Day Trip and Kanye West. Okay, first off, this intro, wonderful. I love how they used real horns for this. It sounds gorgeous. It sounds lush. It sounds like it's very well arranged. The intricacies and the little bits of humanity that come along with real horn sections is so evident. You can even see it in the shaping of the transients here in a way that has a little bit of imperfection or humanity that I don't hear out of VST libraries. And it just feels great. It feels like a king is arriving, which, depending, you know, on who you ask, I mean, Lil Nas X is pretty much royalty at this point. He's incredible. And it's a great entrance into this song, which is just so anthemic and so much about like how he's here to stay. He's not a Old Town Road one trick pony. Baby bet, hey, couple rex, hey, couple Grammys on him, couple plaques, hey, that's a fact, hey, throw it back, hey, throw it back, hey, and this one is okay. Before we get into that, we have this whole main section here. Baby bet, hey, couple. So the horn section, obviously great, but it's actually more dry than I think people expect, because like that tail right here, it's out. It's very tightly produced, and I love that because it gives Lil Nas X's vocals and layers and his effects a little more room to have the ambience and enormity that it does, instead of the horns being so lush and gigantic. They didn't pan every horn out to 1,000% and compress them to death. It sounds like a very organic, real, raw performance that then we have the trappy modern pop elements all sitting on top of, and it works with the contrast. I'm a huge fan of contrast and stuff like this. Baby bet, hey, couple rex, hey, couple Grammys on him. Now, let's break down what's going on in the beat, and then we'll talk about his vocal. Now, it's really interesting because a lot of times I think the default in trap pop blended music, which I would very much call this, is to have the hi-hat just go all through the chorus. But they have a lot of pauses in the hi-hat pattern. And then again. A lot of those two beats, they're pulling the hi-hat out, which I really like. It keeps it from sounding too aggressive, and it sounds really open and just more bombastic and anthemic. Like, that it kind of gives me that kind of an energy. So I really appreciated that. It's just the nuances that make a trap beat feel a little more special than maybe conforming to all the norms of the genre. Now we have two auxiliary main sounds in this beat. We have the hi-hat on the and of one. That's pretty constant as far as being on the and of one. Then we have these little perky babies down in the middle, very tucked in. But it's not just the fact that they're there, it's that these two hits right here. The first hit is just a little woodblock sample, but then the second one has the clap with it that we also use on the backbeat. So it's naked and then duoed and then the clap. So, excuse me, clap beat two, naked woodblock and clap, clap. And it's just interesting. It makes the beat just not feel quite as up the middle, having these two kind of dancing apart and with each other in a nice way. So I love that. And then we have a little bit of pitching in the hi-hat. Pretty common move to be pitching down your hi-hat like that at the end of a phrase. And a little bit of that stutter. Sounds like stutter with pitch. It sounds like on a very quick scale. All right, let's talk about Lil Nas X's vocal here. Baby bet, ay, couple rex, ay, couple Grammys on him, couple plaques, ay, that's a fact, ay, throw it back, ay. Now, his lead here is one Nas up the middle, super bright, super pop vocal, really dry up the middle. And then it gets bigger as we go on. But it's the kind of thing where you don't expect, for being such a big moment, that it'll be just one Lil Nas, but it is. Then we have two little ad libs going on. This first one I hear quite a bit through the song. It's somebody going, ooh. It starts on the left side, pans to the right, and then the woo ends back on the left. That ooh comes around quite a bit. Then there's one little something going on right in this gap. Very tiny, very hard to hear, but I think you'll appreciate it when you do hear it. Oh man, so much to unpack here. Okay. We still have no vocal harmony, it's just layering. So we have doubles now. It sounds like we have a center Nas, but he's very low and the emphasis is on the pan doubles. Still doubles. All doubles there. It's wonderful. Sounds great. Sounds big. It's kind of detached, right? Because when you don't have the center lead, it makes things feel a little incomplete. And then we get it when we hit the downbeat. Now with the instrumentation. Let's talk about the drums first. We have the big hit. And then the claps. Going through. Now it sounds like layered with the claps, they have drumsticks clicking. I have scissors. It sounds like there's drumsticks hitting some rims or some surfaces to add to the claps. Or like you're hitting sticks together. And it definitely makes it feel more lively and human, and definitely leading into the marching band, marching line energy. And then of course we have that. Same hit there. Same fill. Let me go back to the trap beat. So that's everything on the drums. Now with the bass, we have a much cleaner bass that has sustain to it, just up the middle. It's not as big, as wide as the 808. Actually, no, the 808's not that wide either. It's just definitely not as dirty. A lot cleaner. And that could even be made from the same sample. It's hard to tell, to be honest. But definitely a lot cleaner, right? We want to set up that dirt for when it comes back in the hook. And that's really nicely done. And this is where you can start to hear the ad libs and the whoo, hey, like little bits popping up. It's left, right, left. Check this out. There's a two on the right, one on the left on the next line. And they just kind of alternate wherever that seems to be placed. I don't know if there's a super rhyme or reason to it, but again, just a little energy. Ayo, ban out, ban out. That kind of prepares us for only upbeats. And so we're not getting that delicious, huge downbeat until, of course, coming up here. So, a couple of things here. Actually, a lot of things. So let's talk about the bass first. Now, I love that the bass is now a part of dun, 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 that section, the build up. We didn't get that before. And we have one extra hit here. This. That's, excuse me, one extra kick hit there that adds some entry to the beat. Downbeat, and then bah, 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 bah. So it's those little kick drum pickups that helps make the bass and the kick feel a little more exciting than what we had in the first, this first section here. Sounds awesome. Same rest of the beat. Now let's talk about what's happening with the vocals. So it sounds like we have quite a bit more than you may think with the vocals on this. We obviously have the main melody and da 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 ba da 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 da. But he has a really deep voice, and Lil Nas X can pull this off well. It sounds like he's doing a low octave. I can't even dream of doing it, but. Whatever the heck is going on down there. That is also tucked underneath. Similar thing to what he did on Montero, and he's really using his deep tone voice well because he's got the poppy da 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 long ago na na, but he's also using that low tone stank that he can execute with his vocal. So we get a ton more meat out of those side low octave doubles. We get our first harmony of the song right here. I got what they waiting for. It sounds like a third above the low octave. No. It's a third above, and then a fifth, I think, sneaks in on the actual downbeat here. I can't quite tell exactly what it is, to be honest, but it sounds like they're just playing the minor chord, and he's delivering it very softly. So nobody's overpowering that main central Lil Nas. And then we have some interesting... You can hear... It sounds like the octave at this point is four-inch shifted. It's not an organic octave. It sounds like a mangled vocal because I don't think he could do those. You never really talking about me anyway. That low note, I just don't think he could probably do with a low octave. Prove me wrong, Lil Nas X. Stitch this if you end up seeing this piece of content somehow and show me that you can hit that low octave. But it looks like what they did is they used four-inch shifting instead. So it kind of keeps that low tone, that low meat, that low energy, but in a way that's obviously humanly possible. Now throughout this B part of the chorus, two things. One, he is using all these little, the pre-chorus, ay, yeah, yay, yeah. And they're also using that, ooh, all tucked into the back there, which adds, of course, all the energy, all the hype. It's like he has his group with him, his people, in a really nice way. Michelle, you're good to move and do whatever you need to. This mic's a pretty good rejecting sound. Now, let's talk about this part. This is the big moment for me. Now, they have a very apparent third up from the melody happening here. At least four, it sounds like. But they also have some really interesting dissonance happening right here. Wild. And this is something I hear a lot. This is what I call like a pedal tone chorus stack. It sounds like there could be some layers that are tucked in, just singing parts of chord tones, and then the harmony ends up interacting with it in a really cool, interesting way, but it's tucked, so we can't really tell what the harmony is. Now, I can't quite confirm if he's doing that or not, but it sounds very similar to that concept. Or they sang it and then determined which dissonant notes they wanted to keep and which ones they didn't want to keep. But I love that moment. So again, sounds like we have low octave, high octave, third harmony, and a couple of harmonies just singing pitches from the chorus. And then that is it. So it is really beautiful. And again, that's the easiest way to create that kind of dissonance. So that's just kind of why I harp on that concept. And of course, his delivery here, awesome. I love it. I love it. And of course, he's doing the very classic way of punching your lines up. Oh, he didn't say, he said he's a pop guy like Bieber, and then only doubled the huh there. So again, right, a really nice volleying every line. The guys are kind of popping in or not. If I had to guess, it would probably be that they've recorded so many layers, they got doubles in place, and then they decide what words to keep and which ones to not. As far as how you might want to execute that, I can't. I'm not totally sure, but that's how I would assemble that kind of vocal layering. And of course, we have the beat out. We have the horns filtered. And they keep the horns kind of filtered and reserved, and they slowly bring them back up. Oh my god, I didn't hear this before until right now. There's like one horn hit on the downbeat. What? I love that. Day trip. Oh my goodness, you guys. You get me. So he switches from like the ad-libs that are really close, the accenting doubles that are really close, to then very filtered and dissonant. Yeah! Very loose ones. I love just that switch up. It just seems really fun. It seems like they're having a really good time with that, and I appreciate that energy a lot. And then again, very clever playing with the lines and how the beat punches and everything like that. Now, new harmony, and this one is for the champions. And this one is for the champions. Oh, excuse me, it's an octave. That is my fault. I deeply apologize for that. But it's almost a little loosely tuned, and it feels like it has a little more character because of that. Low octave. Low octave. Low octave. Low octave through the whole thing. Now, one thing I want to check. Also sounds like they're using more horn layers here too, which is interesting. So check this out. There's definitely more horn layers in that second free chorus. And I'm on board with it. Now check this out. New ad lib, new energy. The A's. A. Totally new energy into the first half of the chorus there. Interestingly, they kept the breath of his ad lib there. It kind of caught me at the first time I heard it, but just one of the things that my ear pays attention to with vocals and breath. But this one on the right here is still a banger of an ad-lib. A little more bigger ad-libs. We have a full ooh. Same thing there. Nothing, dog, get your soul, just. You're right, so it's not much again. I'm always talking about how the second chorus doesn't need to be that crazily different, but there's enough there to put a lot of intrigue and excitement into the track. My track record. It's kind of the first time we get this reverb swell. My track record so clean, they couldn't wait to just bash me. I must be getting too flashy. Y'all shouldn't have let the world gas me. It's too same thing here, right? We filtered out the hello. So we filtered out the horns. It's Jack's turn to take the stage. Super dry start. Single Jack up the middle. They couldn't wait to just bash me. I must be getting too flashy. Y'all shouldn't have let the world gas me. It's too late because I'm here to stay. And these girls know that I'm nasty. I sent it back to her boy. There's that same note. Nasty. Nasty. Too flashy. Y'all shouldn't just bash me. I must be it's there too. Just bash me. I'm nasty. I sent it back to her boyfriend with my handprint on her ass cheek. City talking, we taking notes. Now, fun fact, I didn't even hear this delay till being on the headphones right now with the ass cheek bit. On her ass cheek. City talking, it's clack 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 clack. Boyfriend with my handprint on her ass cheek. City talking, we taking notes. That sounds cool. I didn't even realize that. I was just thinking about the claps and how it represented the ass cheek that was clapped. But having this little kind of bouncing 16th note delay was really nice. Ass cheek. City talking, we taking notes. And then also we have this filtered 808 that we removed the low end from to make that downbeat hit harder, but they wanted to keep the hit itself, the 808 hit itself. City talking, we taking notes. Tell them all to keep. Then we get all the low end back. Taking notes. Tell them all to keep making posts. Wish he could, but he can't get close. OG's so proud of me that he choking up while he making toast. I'm the type that you can't control. Said I would, then I made it so. I don't clear up rumors. Little delay there. I don't clear up rumors. Where's y'all sense of humor? I'm done making. I also love to Day Trip always does a great job finessing a beat and getting so much excitement out of such brilliant motifs so they can maintain it and just add little flavor and sauce. So check this out. I don't clear up rumors. Where's y'all sense of humor? It's like the first time we cut out the beat hard, like edit the horns out. I don't clear up rumors. Where's y'all sense of humor? I'm done making jokes because they got old like baby boomers. Turn my head. Same thing there with the A's, like the A's kind of punctuate it, and then I'm gonna guess they added the flow, maybe the ad lib, and then they pulled the track out to make the A hit harder. Baby boomers, turn my haters to consumers. I make vets feel like they juniors. Say your time is coming soon, but just like Oklahoma, mine is coming sooner. I'm just a late bloomer. I done peaked. Now, interestingly, this is kind of like their pre-chorus, Jack's pre-chorus time, but his own version. Because this is the only time we have the bass line doing this movement, right? The. And this one is for the champion. That's the only time we have that movement is here. Mine is coming sooner. I'm just a late bloomer. I didn't peak in high school. But they picked a bass that's a little midsier and clumpier, a little thinner, but then they're also including some other energy. Like the hi-hat, which you don't typically get. It was typically class. So I love that the switch up out here. And then we're getting the top, right? We're getting the backbeat. And then a little harkening back to the first two pre-choruses. Claps, snare fill. So we give them a little taste of home, and then we bring them back home. So great simple departure here that really glued in how much I love Day Trip's work, how much I love everybody's work, because it's just moments like these where I'm like, oh, that feels so perfect, so perfectly done. Of course, we have the ad libs going on here. I got what they waiting for. And I love that he turned that ad-lib into just part of the hook. Really anyway. If there's stuff different here, it's so subtle that I'm even having trouble picking it up. But that's the beautiful thing about having a great hook. Sometimes you can keep it simple and it works totally fine. And this will be interesting to see the lighting adjustment of how I can totally see that's popping up on the camera, but it's fine. Oh. Same thing here, the yeah. But this time it's got a bunch of reverb on it as opposed to last time before Jack started, I think. Oh, I lied. I'm wrong. I am wrong. I'm so sorry. Now, interestingly enough, we get the same pre-chorus section as an outro, and now the claps are a lot heavier sounding. You have a little marching loop going on here. It sounds like them just stomping on the ground a bunch. Let me get a little more high horns. I can't even sing, but there's a high tonic note up there. That's but octave up. Again, right? It just makes us feel, it makes it feel final, having an extra high note there. Just kind of triumphantly throughout the outro. Now again, with those stomps though, you don't feel it. You don't hear it. But trust me, listen to this. Compared to this. Huge, huge. And I love the long delay tail here. Yeah. Yeah, yeah. And that is everything in Industry Baby. A wild ride, and I'm so glad you came along the journey. If you made it this far, I would love to know in a comment down below. And I appreciate you for your time today. I know there's a lot you could do with your time and energy, so the fact that you're spending here with me does really mean the world. If you enjoyed this video and you've already left a comment, you've already done all the things to help me pray to the algorithm gods for their blessing, then I would love to keep up with you on social media. Make sure to follow me on socials. Send me a message and let me know you came from this video so I can make sure to follow you back. I would love to keep up with what you're doing in your world. Until next time, get out there, work hard, and remember, kindness wins.